So for the record, this is January 8th, 2011. We're here for an informal music event. And I'm Jack Kodick, and this is our house in Brookline. I want to say a couple of words. We all have a formal music event, except if you all get dressed up. We're having an informal music event, but there's also another kind of music event, which is a completely informal music event. And that's where there's some musicians, a couple of instruments, and nobody knows who's going to do what. And we actually had one here a couple of years ago. And one of the guys played the Bach Chromatic Fantasy and Fugue, which at that time I had not heard for many years, and I didn't even remember the name of the piece. But it made a great impression on me. I've been thinking about it ever since. And for that reason, that's the first thing on the program. And Damien will play it if he's in the room. Where is Damien?
Hello.
There you are. On all cell phones should be off.
Yeah.
Is that all on turn off?
Yeah.
suite, Bach wrote six unaccompanied cello suites, meaning there's cello alone, no piano or anything else. And as you can see, this is the fifth of the six of them. They all had the same movements. They all had a prelude, and the allemande, and the courant, and so forth on down. The first suite was very light and simple and innocent, and then the last suite is just really full of bravura and everything. In fact, it was written for an instrument that has five strings, not just a standard four that the cello had. Two of the suites are minor, more somber mood, and this is one of those. And also, what's very unusual is Bach asked the cellist to tune the cello one string to something other pitch than normal. Most of the time, the cello is going to be tuned, the highest string is A, and then D, G, and C. And he put in the music and asked the cellist to tune the A string down one whole step to G. So now you actually have two G strings. And it just changes the whole sonority. Some notes that wouldn't ring out so much in the regular tuning now ring lots, and vice versa, of course. And there's a wonderful word for this. It's called scordatura. And actually, you know, most people who aren't string players don't even know that word, because it's just for strings if a composer's asked for one or more strings to be tuned other than, usually down, once in a while up, but that almost, you know, you're scared to do that, you don't want to break the string if you put more tension on it, but down. So that's called scordatura.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.